print, email, Facebook, Twitter. More Tasmanian flood damage bill hits $20 million as insurance claims pour in after wild weather. The damage bill from flooding in southern Tasmania is $20 million and rising, according to the Insurance Council of Australia. That figure relates to private homes and businesses and does not include damage to public assets. The council said insurers had now been hit with more than 2,150 private claims and that number was expected to grow as the full scale of the devastation became clearer. The council's Campbell Fuller said it was too early to provide a breakdown of the claims, but it was clear Hobart's CBD and southern suburbs had been the hardest hit. It's very much about residential property damage, as well as some motor vehicle claims. We've seen plenty of vision of vehicles being washed down streets and those kind of things, he told ABC Radio Hobart. We encourage anyone who has been affected to contact their insurers because their insurers are standing by to provide the guidance they require. There were reports of some Tasmanians being stranded without cover, due to a policy distinction between rain inundation and flood water cover. But Mr. Fuller said he knew of only a handful of cases which had been problematic, with 96-97% of the policies on the market including flood cover. Householders and small businesses make a decision about whether they want flood cover or not, he said. Anyone who hasn't elected to have flood cover may strike some difficulties if, in fact, their properties were flooded rather than suffering storm damage. He said most calls for help were related to clean-up issues and urged affected residents and businesses to get on with it. Media Player, Space to Play, M to Mute, Left and Right to Seek, 00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00:00: advice to get claims moving. Get rid of anything that poses a health hazard and take photographs and get them out of the property as quickly as you can. You don't need festering moldy furniture and carpets in your property, he said. Many properties in the hardest hit areas of Molesworth and Lachlan, north of Hobart, remain cut off by floodwaters after fast flowing water washed away local bridges and damaged roads. The Derwent Valley Council has estimated bridge repair costs will run into the millions and it is in talks with the state and federal governments about funding relief. But residents have told the ABC they fear any such works could take weeks, or even months. Insurance issues still linger from North's 2016 floods. Latrobe Mayor Peter Freshney said the floods in the south felt like deja vu, with the 2016 floods that devastated the region still fresh in the minds of many in his community. We've got two or three families still out of their homes, and we're almost 2 years past the fact, he said. They are still battling to get back into their homes because of insurance issues and battles to get compensation. His advice to southern mayors was to persevere and that community-led recovery was the best type of recovery. It will be a long and drawn-out process but it's a matter of persevering, he said. Councillor Freshney said insurance battles could be frustrating and lengthy. I thought there might be a review of the insurance provisions and the wording within policies generally, after the 2016 floods, as there were after the Queensland floods, he said. It's just total devastation south of the city. The cleanup continued at Kingston's Channel Court Shopping Centre, which sustained heavy damage in the deluge. While the larger stores were open on Monday, a number of stores in the centre were still closed, with authorities working to clean areas of the ground flood and car park. Newsagent Mike Ditch said the recovery process was daunting. It's just total devastation. There's nothing really that hasn't been touched, he said. I don't know how many weeks we'll be out of action. Our computers have been drowned. We missed out on the biggest or second biggest trading day of the year, Mother's Day, which hurt us a lot. Kingborough Council also sustained significant damage to its civic centre and was open for urgent inquiries only. Mayor Steve West said the council's works department received more calls in a day on Friday than it usually did in a month, and staff were prioritising the clean-up works. It's gone past disbelief and it's now into a numbness mode where you think, what do you do and how do you beat it? Councillor West said, I'm sure council, and I'm sure local business, will look at it after to think, what can we do to prevent it again and what can we do to lessen it? The banks of the Newtown rivulet burst, with debris, including cars, swept into it by the floodwaters, supplied. Mark Horseman image 1 of 22. George Vickers snapped this image of the water catching people by surprise in the Hobart CBD. Supplied. George Vickers image 2 of 22. A home at Sandy Bay, Hobart, sustained extensive damage to its roof in the storm, submitted. Rohanbury Image 3 of 22. Police sought help on social media to find the owner of this yacht, aground at Bruny Island, supplied. Tasmania Police Image 4 of 22. Cleanup underway inside a shop in the Channel Court shopping complex in Kingston, May 11, 2018. ABC News. Ellen Call to Image 5 of 22. Search and rescue personnel watches a 15-year-old boy is prepared to be winched to safety by a helicopter after becoming trapped in fast-running floodwaters at Tinwild Park, New Norfolk, supplied. Tasmania Police Image 6 of 22. The Westpac rescue helicopter moves into position for the rescue operation at New Norfolk, in southeast Tasmania, supplied. Tasmania Police Image 7 of 22. The boy is lifted out of the floodwaters at New Norfolk, in southeast Tasmania, supplied. Tasmania Police Image 8 of 22. The flood caused extensive damage at the Sandy Bay campus of the University of Tasmania. ABC News. Brian Miller's Image 9 of 22. At Opossum Bay, the storm caused a landslip, resulting in this dwelling sliding down an embankment, supplied. Peter Tucker Image 10 of 22. Hobart docks thick with debris from storm and flooding, supplied. David Chalmers Image 11 of 22. Hundreds of cars were damaged, with a massive insurance bill expected following the 1-in-100-year flood. ABC News. Carla Howarth Image 12 of 22. A car which did not make it through flood waters on Lena Valley Road. ABC News. Georgie Burgess Image 13 of 22. Cars floating in South Hobart, supplied. Lisa Cawthon Image 14 of 22. Water comes down a hallway in UTAS's engineering faculty, Sandy Bay, Hobart, supplied. Monty Bovill Image 15 of 22. Sandbags and a police presence in Hobart city centre, ABC News. Edith Beverney Image 16 of 22. Sam Eichen's family awoke to water coming into their home in Blackmans Bay, Hobart, supplied. Sam Eichen Image 17 of 22. Emergency crews clean up mud and debris from the CBD. News video Image 18 of 22. The Hobart CBD has been left covered in mud and debris after a storm overnight, May 11, 2018. ABC. Edith Beverney Image 19 of 22. Cars swept away by flash flooding piled up in Hobart CBD, May 11, 2018. ABC. Edith Beverney Image 20 of 22. Staff try to sweep floodwaters out of the old Woolstore Hotel in Hobart CBD, May 11, 2018. ABC. Edith Beverney Image 21 of 22. The storm brought with it widespread lightning, including a strike which took out a transmission tower, putting ABC television and radio off air for hours. Supplied. Matt Osborne Image 22 of 22. Print, email, Facebook.